Hey everyone, this is Sid back with another video, and this is the continuation of offensive hacking and exploitation. In this video we will do the rest of the exploitation. Okay, let's begin. So in this video we will use Windows bind TCP shellcode. So what bind TCP shellcode does, it's pop a shell on victim's computer and bind to a specific port. After that the attacker connect to the victim's computer and run any commands he want. Now when we are creating shellcode using MSF Venom, we need to give a remote host. This will be the victim's IP address, and remote port will be the port where our shellcode bind to. By default we need not give our host and our port while our shellcode is generating, because when our shellcode run it will bind to available interface and port number will be 4444. So let's jump to our demo section and do the rest of the exploitation. Okay, let's generate our shellcode without the bad characters. So I will use MSF Venom to do that. Save Venom. Payload will be Windows shell bind TCP. Architecture is x86, and here we will put all the bad characters. So first bad character will be our null byte. After that x0a, and then 60t. Okay, let's find out. Yes, okay. Now the format we need is CRA format. Let's generate our shellcode. Okay, our shellcode is here, and the size is 355 bytes, and it is encoded by Shikataka Nai. Shikataka Nai is a polymorphic encoder which spit out the shellcode for us. Let's copy it. Let's open the server. Now we need to delete this all hex character from here. Let's delete it. Let's put our shellcode. Paste it here. Now that's it. Okay, let's save it, run our server. Now our server is running. Let's get back to our victim machine. Open NFTP, attach it with immunity. Open the malicious link. port. Now you can notice that instead of crashing NFTP client, it is running. This is a good news for us. Let's go to our attacker machine. Our our victim machine IP address is 192.168.43.227. Now we will use Netcat utility to connect to our remote shell. Let's write down NC. Our victim machine IP address is 192.168.43.227, and the port where we need to connect to is 4444, because this is the default port which we previously discussed in slide. Let's hit an enter, and here is our little shell. Now we are into the victim machine. Let me run system info command. Now our command runs successfully and it gives back all the information of the system. And you can see we are inside victim machine. Okay, let's list out all the running programs into victim's computer. And these are the all programs which is currently running into victim's machine. And our shellcode run within the context of NFTP. Okay, let's go to the desktop. Now let's create a text file with some text in it. Now let's get back to our victim machine. Minimize this, and you can see the text file is here. Let's open it into victim's computer. And if we go to the victim machine, it not appeared here. If we do exit from the terminal and the text file is just opened, and give the text in it. Okay, this is it for this video. In next video I will take another application and take a different approach to exploit it. If you really like this video, give me a thumbs up, share among your friends, and I really appreciate your comments.